Hello, welcome to my channel TechGee. Today my topic is block diagram of microcomputer. It is architecture of any microcomputer in terms of block diagram. Here in the figure, we can see the different parts of a microcomputer. Here you can see various types of buses such as address bus, data bus, control bus, input device, keyboard, keyboard interface, output device, display and display interface, microprocessor unit or also called as CPU, ROM, RAM, clock and some power lines and power supply. We will see each of these blocks one by one. Very first is bus. A bus is a conducting lines which carries electronics data. There are mainly three types of buses: address bus, data bus and control bus. Address bus is unidirectional. From MPU, it sends an address of the required memory on this bus. Data bus is bidirectional data bus. From the MPU, data can be transferred to the devices and vice versa. Whereas in control bus, control signals are carried on this bus, which are generated by CPU and later on transferred on this bus to drive the required block of the system. Next is input devices. Here it is keyboard. We can enter data or instruction through keyboard. This data or instruction enters in the keyboard interface, which is a special chip. Keyboard interface is connected to address bus, chip select and control lines. The data from keyboard will not directly send to the MPU or CPU. As MPU may be busy in doing other work or previous instruction work, or the speed of the input device and MPU may not be equal, because we all know the speed of CPU is much more than the user. Now, the keyboard interface sends an interrupt signal. Here it is, an interrupt signal to the MPU to tell the data or instructions are ready to dispatch. After completion of the current work in hand or current instruction, CPU stops the normal execution and jumps to a special group of instructions in its monitor program, which gives response to the keyboard data. It is entered in the keyboard interface already. MPU generates control signals and chip select signals here to activate the keyboard interface, and MPU tells it to send the data on data bus. Then MPU accepts the data. Here MPU or CPU, that is microprocessor unit or central processing unit, one and the same. The main functions of MPU is to receive the information in digital form, to process the information by means of arithmetic and logical operations, and to send the result or information in standard form. Here, the next unit is ROM, that is called as read-only memory. It allows only reading stored information. It is also called as program memory. Fixed store program called monitor programs are in ROM. It has address bus, chip select and read control lines or read signal lines. The next unit is RAM, that is random access memory. It is also called as read write memory. That is data memory, and bidirectional bus is required. Here you can see bidirectional bus. It is required to read and write data from the memory. RAM has address input lines and chip select read or write enable lines. Then the next unit is output device is display, that is connected with display interface. The data stored from other devices is stored in display interface. Then this display interface sends the data to display device, that is monitor. Next is address decoder. It collects the data from the MPU and selects the proper device to send this data. Next is clock. With the clock, the whole circuitry is synchronized. The speed of the system depends on clock frequency. More is the clock frequency, more is the speed of the computer. This circuit is connected to MPU. Next is power lines. All the blocks are connected to power lines because power supply is necessary to operate the circuits. So, one more point is interrupt line is there. It is used to give interrupt signals to the microprocessor or microprocessor unit. So, in short, we have seen about the block diagram of a microcomputer. Hope you understood this. Thank you.